Hi everyone, welcome to an overview of Apache APISIX plugins. My name is Bobur, I am a developer advocate, and today I'm going to present to you some of Apache APISIX built-in plugins and briefly explain their usage, also talk about low-code plugin orchestration. So let's get started. Plugins are additional components that can be plugged into the gateway. Plugins can specialize components behavior to exactly fit your needs and your technical constraints. When using APISIX, you must be faced with multiple types of plugins. And currently, it has more than 50 built-in plugins broken down into several categories. It covers authentication, security, traffic control, serverless, observability, and other aspects to meet the common usage scenarios of all customers. As shown in the architecture diagram, Apache APISIX is divided into two parts. The control plane sends down all the configuration details to etcd, and at the same time, the data plane handles all internal and external traffic with the help of rich plugins. APISIX exposed set of interfaces that allow us to bind plugins to the API. Let's walk through some commonly used plugins.
A modern API gateway acts as a single entry point and can apply many different authentication mechanisms by default, including HTTP basic auths, API keys based auths, or OpenID connect JWT to validate the token on the behalf of your API. So a developer doesn't have to add any code in your API to process the authentication. JWT plugin is one strategy for API gateway authentication too. JWT simplifies authentication setup, allowing you to focus more on coding and less on security.
There are more authentication plugins available under authentication category like Kios, IDEP, or OpenID Connect, which allows the integration with third-party identity providers, IDP, and in many standard way. IP restrictions can be enabled for security reasons. There are the users will be allowed to log in only from range of IP address as defined by the system or by your microservice. If the user tries to log in outside the allowed range, the system simply throws an error and login will not be possible. So we can do it with APISIX restriction plugin. You can restrict access to your service or a route.
There are many API security best practices such as making use of TLS encryption, setting API firewalls, validating request data, throttling for protection, or using dedicated Apache APISIX gateway deployment where you can use plugins and secure the traffic from beginning to the end.
Rate limiting is a strategy for limiting network traffic. It puts a cap on how often someone can repeat an action within a certain time frame. For instance, trying to log into an account, rate limiting can help stop certain kind of malicious activities. It can also reduce strain on web servers. Apache APISIX limit count plugin is one of type of request limiting plugins. It limits the request rate by a fixed number of requests in a given time window. It means how many HTTP requests can be made in given period of, let's say, seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, or years. There are other traffic control plugins as well, like limit concurrency or limit request or traffic split. You can use them per your need. API monitoring is the process of collecting and analyzing data about the performance of your API in order to identify problems that impact users. If your application is running slowly, and you must first understand the cause before you can correct it. Modern applications use many independent microservices instead of a few large monoliths, right? And one poor performing service can definitely impact the overall performance of an application. In addition to this, isolating single poor performing service among the hundreds can be challenging. But if you use API gateway, you can measure API performance in multi-cloud environment easily. APISIX Prometheus plugin can fetch API metrics data, and you can show this metrics exported by the plugin in Grafana.
API observability is an ability to understand system behavior and investigate the interactions between an application's components. APISIX offers many observability plugins. For example, HTTP Logger is a plugin which pushes log data requests to HTTP or HTTPS servers. This will provide the ability to send log data requests in JSON format to monitoring tools such as Prometheus and other HTTP servers. Serverless is a cloud-native development model that allows developers to build and run applications without having to manage servers. There are two plugins for Serverless Apache APISIX offers, namely Serverless Prefunction and Serverless Postfunction. One just runs at the beginning of specified phase, the other at the end of specified phase. Apache APISIX provides support for serverless frameworks. For popular cloud vendors like Azure Functions, AWS Lambda, and more coming on the way. Sometimes your service requires you to use many plugins together or create a custom plugins. APISIX offers two solutions respectively, plugin orchestration and plugin development. Plugin orchestration is a form of low code that can help enterprises reduce usage costs and increase operation. Either way, we can easily orchestrate all the plugins offered by APISIX. We can just drag and drop and put together these plugins. The orchestrated plugins can share contextual information to realize scenario-based requirements. As you can see, the APISIX dashboard lists the currently available plugins and the drawing boards. We can drag and drop the plugins onto the drawing board to arrange them. You can learn more about APISIX dashboard in my another video tutorial. I will leave the link below. Plugins are important mechanism in APISIX. By using it, we can create high-performance systems under tight deadlines. With Apache APISIX, we can write custom plugins in a programming language we are familiar with, including Go, Python, Java, Lua, PHP, and more. If you would like to write plugins in other languages that's not listed above, you can refer to Apache APISIX documentation. As you can see, we have currently supported plugin runners Java, Go, Python, and JavaScript. But if you would like to run in other languages, you can use external plugin, or if you want to have more information about existing plugin runners, you can just check out the documentation about each plugin runner
like Go, Python, Java.
Now you have a solid foundation about Apache APISIX plugins. If you would like to improve existing plugins or introduce new ones, you can join our community on Slack or simply subscribe to our mailing list. Thank you for watching.